Dear students, today I am going to discuss some maths from the chapter Whole Numbers for Maths Olympiad. So today's first problem is 144 can be represented by 12 × 12 square grid. Which of the following can also be represented on a square grid? So the options are A is 39, option B is 50, option C is 70, and option D is 81. So here 144 can be represented by 12 × 12. So here among these four numbers, only 81 can be represented as 9 × 9, because 9 × 9 is equals to 81. I hope all of you understood. Next, (25 × 22) = (25 × 25) is an example of which property? The options are commutative, option B associative, option C closure, and option D distributive. So this one is associative property. Now next problem. Which of the following statements is not true? Option A is every whole number has a successor. Option B, every whole number has a predecessor. Option C, 0 is the least whole number and option D, every natural number is a whole number. So these are the four options. Among these, one is incorrect and rest of the three are correct. So first option is every whole number has a successor. So before that, you have to know that what are the whole numbers. So whole numbers are starting from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, and that all the positive numbers are called whole numbers. And what are the natural numbers? Natural numbers starting from 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then all the positive numbers are natural numbers. So students, here the last option, you can see that every natural number is a whole number. Yes, the natural numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, and every natural numbers are in the whole number. So that means option D is correct. Okay, option C, 0 is the least whole number. Yes, because whole numbers are starting from 0, so 0 is the least whole number. It is also correct option. Then option A, every whole number has a successor. Obviously, successor means plus 1. So 0 plus 1 is 1, is whole number. 1 plus 1 is 2, is a whole number. 2 plus 1 is a 3, is a whole number. 3 plus 1 is equals to 4, it is also a whole number. So option A is also correct. Now option B. Option B is every whole number has a predecessor. So that means, predecessor means subtract 1. You have to subtract 1 from the number. So if we subtract, so as we know that 0 is the least whole number. So if we subtract 1 from 0, then it will be minus 1. So minus 1 is not a whole number. So option B is incorrect. So which of the following statement is not true? Option B is not true. I hope all of you understood. Next problem. If A and B are two whole numbers, then commutative law is applicable on subtraction if and only if the options are, if A is equals to B, option B, if A not equals to B, option C, if A greater than B, and option D, if A less than B. So students, we know that A minus B is equals to B minus A is not true. It is impossible that A minus B is equals to B minus A, because 5 minus 3 is 2, but 3 minus 5 is minus 2. So these are not equal. So here it is possible only when, it is possible only when, if A is equals to B, because A minus B is 0 and also B minus A is 0, if A is equal to B, if both numbers are equal. So if both, now suppose both numbers are 5, so then 5 minus 5 is equals to 0, and also 5 minus 5 is equals to 0. So only, it is possible only when A is equals to B. Understood? Next. Next problem. Which property states that the sum of any two whole numbers is always a whole number? The options are option A, commutative, option B, closure, option C, associative, and option D, additive. So which property states that the sum of any two whole numbers is always a whole number? So students, all of you know that it is which property? It is obviously closure property. Closure property states that the sum of any two whole numbers is always a whole number. Next problem. Which of the following is not true? The options are 7 plus 8 plus 9 is equals to 7 plus 8 plus 9. And option D, 7 multiply 8 plus 9 is equals to 7 multiply 8 plus 7 multiply 9. So these are the option. So you can easily say that which is correct option and which is not true. So here this one is correct, option B is also correct, and option D is also correct, because these are the properties that you have learnt already. So here you can see that option C will be, option C is incorrect, because in the left hand side it will be 79, and to the right hand side it will be different. So option C is obviously correct answer. Next problem. The whole number which does not have a predecessor is, the options are 9, 1, 0, and 100. So here students, these are all whole numbers. Among these numbers, which one does not have a predecessor? So if we subtract 1. If we subtract 1 from the numbers 9, 1 and 100, 1 whole number will be there. But if we subtract 1 from 0, it will be minus 1. I repeat once again. If we subtract 9, if we subtract 1 from 9, it will be 8. So 8 is a whole number. If we subtract 1 from 1, is equals to 0, which is a whole number. If we subtract 1 from 100, it is 99, so it is also a whole number. But if we subtract 1 from 0, then it will be minus 1. So minus 1 is not a whole number. So which whole number does not have the predecessor? Obviously 0. Next. Additive identity of whole numbers is option A is 1, option B is 0, option C is 2, and option D is both A and B. So additive identity of whole numbers is 0. You better know that additive identity of whole numbers is 0. So students, this kind of maths will come in your upcoming maths olympiad exam. So you must practice such kind of maths at your home. Now next problem. If A is equals to 35, B is equals to 11, and C is equals to 23, then find A multiply C minus B. So the options are, option A is 375, option B is 495, option C is 235, and option D is 420. So the value given, A is equals to 35, B is equals to 11, and C is equals to 23. Then we have to find the value of A multiply of C minus B. So here the value of A is 35. So 35 multiply C. C means 23 minus B. B is 11. So its value will be, so 23 minus 11 is obviously 12. Now students, calculate 35 multiply 12. So let me check that what will be the answer. So 420. So if you multiply 35 with 12, you can find that 420 is the correct answer. So option D is the correct answer. And if you want, you can calculate it directly. Need not to show this calculation. You can solve it directly. So students, you must practice such kind of maths at your home and for your upcoming maths olympiad exam. And Next, students, you have to remember that additive identity of whole numbers is 0. Additive identity of whole numbers is 0 and multiplicative identity is always 1. Okay? You have to remember that multiplicative identity multiplicative identity is 1. I repeat once again that additive identity is 0 and multiplicative identity is 1. Okay, students? So practice at your home. Thank you, everyone.